Hi guys, Charlie here. In the comment section of one of my last videos, Lucy wrote,
"Why do geese fly in a V formation? How do they decide who's in front?"
Wonderful questions, Luce. Bam, bam. We got two geese-related questions. The first, why they fly in a V formation, and the second one, who leads the pack? Let's put that one aside and start with this one right here, why they fly in V's. To answer this question, we need to look at what happens in the air when a goose flaps its wings. So let's take a closer look at that. Behold, a majestic goose flying through the air, flapping its wings. As this beautiful goose flaps its wings, these tiny vortexes of air roll off those wingtips and kind of swirl into the sky behind it. Here's what it looks like from the back, right? We have these vortexes of air swirling behind the goose, off its wings, into the space behind it, and then disappearing. These swirls of air, super important. Let's check it out. If we pause that vortex of air as it's directly behind the goose, we'll notice that it's pointing downward. Behind the goose, air going down. If we pause that vortex on the outside of the goose's wing right here, we'll notice that the air is going up. So the air is going up outside the wing. Behind the goose, the air goes down. Outside of the wing, it goes up. Now, imagine you are a goose. This is you. Where should I fly? If you line up directly behind the goose, the air swirling off the wings of the goose in front of you is going to be pushing you down, which will make flying very difficult and frustrating and generally, tougher. All right, so you don't want to fly behind the goose, but what happens if you fly kind of like off to the side? What happens there, right?
Instead of the air pushing downwards, you're off the wing where the air is pushing upwards.
So you'll get a tiny little lift up in the air, which will help keep you aloft and make flying a little bit easier. You don't want to be directly behind the goose. You want to be off to the side. With that in our minds, let's line up some geese. Here's our lead goose. Wonderful.
Beautiful.
Wonderful. This is the area where geese don't want to fly, and this is the area where they do want to fly. So we'll put one here, and then we'll put one over here, right? Now let's line some up behind these guys. This is the part where things get a little bit complicated, but it's where we start forming that V. So we got two options of places to fly behind this goose. Which one to go in? If we're over here, we're going to get a little lift by this goose in front. But if you think about it, the air coming off the wings of the goose, two gooses in front of us, is going to be going downwards, pushing us down. So even though we get some lift here, this stuff pushes us down, making it kind of like a very turbulent area.
So that wouldn't be a great place to fly. But this spot over here is different. It only has a little bit of lift created by the goose directly in front of it, making it the perfect spot to fly. So we'll line up there. Great. This side on the right is pretty much the same thing. It's just completely mirrored. So we'll go here.
OMG. Would you look at that? We get a V. Oh, brilliant. Wonderful. That might have been a little confusing, but basically it comes down to this, right? Geese line up in a formation where they get a little lift from the goose flying in front of them. And it just so happens that that formation is in a perfect V from the sky. Boom, bam, wonderful, great. First question answered. Let's talk about this second question. Who's in front? This is a great question, especially keeping in mind what we just learned. If you were flying in the air, personally, I would never want to fly in front. Because while all these geese are getting a little lift and help flying, right, this goose is just doing it all himself. It's, you have to do the most work. Who wants to fly in there? Not me. Well, it just so turns out that the answer to this is kind of simple and kind of wonderful. Geese just cooperate with each other, and that's pretty much the answer. So you have a bunch of geese flying, right? It just kind of turns out that the one in front will fly in front until it's tired. They'll be like, oh shoot, I'm a little tired. Guys, you got me? And they're like, we got you. And he just flies in back of the line and everybody moves up and then you have a new leader. They're like, thanks. And they're like, no problem, goose brother. We are a family and we cooperate with each other. That's it. Geese cooperate. A goose will lead the V until it gets tired and then it'll move back and then another goose will be in front until it gets tired, which is really delightful. Anytime anybody's giving you trouble, just be like, hey, be like a goose and cooperate. Oh my gosh, since we got some geese on hand, let's squeeze in one more question from Carson and Miss Hoyle's class.
Carson wants to know, why do birds fly south in the winter?
Great question, Carson. Let's ask these geese. Hello, geese.
What?
Be nice! Yeah. Don't be rude, Jerry!
Fine! What do you want?
Hi, we have a couple questions for you.
We're a little busy right now.
No, we're not. Questions are great.
Yeah.
What are they?
Great. Where are you guys heading today?
Rancho San Fernando.
That's in Mexico.
It's beautiful.
You'd love it.
We're going to Mexico.
Yeah.
Nice. Hey, where are you guys from?
We're from Wollaston Lake.
That's in Saskatchewan.
That's in Canada.
You'd love that too.
Just as beautiful.
Why do you go there in the winter? Why do you fly south?
Well, in the winter, there isn't much food in Canada.
Everything's frozen.
Yeah.
And it's much warmer down south.
So nice.
And there's also a lot of food.
So much.
And just generally more resources that we can use to survive.
Yeah.
Rancho San Fernando.
Beautiful.
Really, you'd love it.
Hey, well, thank you very much for your time.
No problem.
No problem.
Have a good
Thanks,
one.
Dear.
Be well now.
What a nice man.
Such a sweetheart.
Reminds me of Wollaston.
Well, how about that? What a nice group of polite geese. Awesome. Thanks, Carson, for your question. Thanks, Lucy, for both of your questions. And special shout out to Miss Hoyle's first grade class. How was your winter break, guys? I hope it was fantastic. Oh my gosh, since we're thanking everybody, let's thank these people right here. These are the people supporting me on Patreon. Patreon's like a Kickstarter place where you can give creators some monetary support. In exchange for that support, you get cool perks like, bam, getting your name at the end of these videos. If you'd like to check out Patreon and get your name over here in this group, click over here. If you'd like to subscribe, click over here. And oh my gosh, guys, have you seen this one yet? I really enjoyed this, and I think you will too. So check it out. Thanks. Goodbye.